Hey everybody, this is a 1992 set of Donruss baseball cards. This is Series 2 set. I've already done a video on the Series 1, and the 92 factory set is comprised of the Series 1 and the Series 2. There's my cat. He's laying on the footrest of my recliner. And I'm going to sit here and flip through this hand-collated set of baseball cards. And I'm going to pull out the few cards that I deem worth anything. You see, these are 1990s baseball cards. And there were so many of them produced that there's just not much value in most of these cards. Yeah, the sad fact is most of these cards are completely worthless. Now, the 92 set that you see before your eyes it's a nice set. The card stock that they used for 92 was better than 91. And these cards were pulled from the individual foil packs. You know, you could get a foil pack for like a dollar, or I forget the actual cost. And that's where these cards came from. Now, I already see a card that I'm going to keep. It's Jim Thome. And what can you say about Jim Thome? I mean, yeah, he was a Indians first baseman, a designated hitter. He played 22 seasons in the majors. He played for a few different teams, but, you know, most of that time was for the Cleveland Indians. He was a power hitter, no doubt. He was pretty prolific in that role. I mean, he hit like 612 home runs during his career. You know, that's the eighth most all time. His batting average was 276. You know, Jim Thome, he was a member of 5 All-Star teams. And he won a Silver Slugger Award. What else can I say about him? You know, he was part of a group of players that led the franchise to, two World Series appearances during the mid-90s. He spent 10 years with the tribe before leaving, free agency, you know. I think he went to the Phillies after he left the Indians. Yeah, there was a lot of good photography in this set. There's another one that I'm going to keep. Bo Jackson. A lot of people don't know that his full name is Vincent Edward Jackson. And I guess most everyone knows that not only did he play professional baseball, he played professional football. As a matter of fact, he's the only professional athlete in history to be named an all-star in both baseball and football. And I guess because he was so good at both of those sports, it's given him a reputation, I guess, as being one of the greatest athletes of all time. He played college football for Auburn. He was a running back. He won a Heisman Trophy in '85. So when he got to the NFL, he played for the Los Angeles Raiders. And, in Major League Baseball, he played for the Kansas City Royals and the Chicago White Sox and the California Angels. And he was inducted into the Hall of College Football Hall of Fame in '96. And then, I don't know if any of you are old enough to remember the commercials. Bo knows best, the Nike commercials. So I think Bo Diddley was in those commercials too, I think, yeah. Yeah, I guess it was there's a 1991 hip injury that ended Bo's football career, and his baseball career ended in '94. You know, there's a lot of great cards in this set. A lot of good photography. But they're not worth anything. The card companies, they just made so many cards during this time. And they just saturated the market, that there's just no collectability in these cards. Now, I am going to keep this one, the Gossage Ryan combo card. Yeah, this particular card, it's called a combo card because there's two guys on it, but this one commemorates, Nolan Ryan's 308th win and Gossage's 308th save. And it was in the same game against the Red Sox. Gossage was a relief pitcher. I don't even really know his first name. We just called him Goose, but he was one of, a few pitchers that basically had just one pitch. It was a fastball. It was a very potent fastball. It's probably one of the best of all time. I think he was routinely throwing in the 98 to 102 mile per hour range. when, you know, in his prime. But he was doing it with pinpoint accuracy. Yeah, he had a reputation as a no-nonsense, no-frills pitcher. And he, you know, he wasted no time. You know, when you only throw one kind of pitch, you don't need to do much communicating with a catcher. So as soon as the batter would you know, stand in, you know, Gossage was ready to pitch. Then he pitched in 3 World Series. And he was, 9 All-Star appearances? And then, you know, Nolan Ryan, I mean, geez, what can you say about him? You know, we called him the Ryan Express. 27 years in the majors. He pitched for the Mets, the Angels, the Astros, and then the Rangers. You know, Ryan was inducted into the Hall of Fame in 99. He's a right-handed pitcher. And he had a good fastball. I mean, you know, his pitches were clocked a lot of times over 100 miles an hour. And the thing about him is that he maintained that kind of velocity throughout his entire pitching career. There's a Don Mattingly card. Yeah, we're going to keep that one, too. Yeah, people called him the Hitman or Donnie Baseball. He spent his entire 14-year career playing with the New York Yankees. He was on the American League All-Star team 6 times. He won 9 Gold Glove Awards, 3 Silver Slugger Awards. At one point, he won an American League batting title. In 85, he was American League Most Valuable Player. He was captain of the Yankees for a few years. You know, when the Yankees retired his uniform number 23, it made him the only Yankee to have his number retired without having won a World Series with the team. Yeah, Don Mattingly, this sad part, you know, he's really good, but he never received enough votes to be inducted into the Major League Hall of Fame. And you only get so many tries. And his eligibility expired eventually. So once you're no longer eligible, that's it. Yeah, looking at these cards makes me want to keep so many of them. You know, for nostalgic reasons. But in the end, I have to remind myself that they're just cardboard. Like that Tom Glavine, I would, you know, maybe I'll go back and pull that one out. I don't know. It's not worth anything. Now we're going to keep that Mike Mussina. Yeah, I want to keep that one. You know, Mike Mussina was a... He had a nickname. It was Moose. He was a starting pitcher. He played 18 seasons in the majors for the Baltimore Orioles. And he also played for the Yankees. It took him, six years to be, to before he finally got enough votes to be, elected into the Baseball Hall of Fame. He was a 5-time All-Star, a 7-time Gold Glove winner. I don't guess he ever won a Cy Young award, but, he had 6 top 5 finishes in the voting for the, for his league's Cy Young award. I'm at an age where I just want to kind of thin out possessions. And I do have a lot of baseball cards. And so let me rephrase that. I have a lot of worthless baseball cards. That's because I was collecting in the 90s. I think my wife actually enjoyed collecting these cards more than I did. I mean, when she got wind of what I was doing and I explained it to her and let her open up a few packs. Boy, that was it. She loves baseball, and she was hooked on the cards at that point. My son loves the cards too, but he's pretty savvy. And he knows that very few of these cards are worth anything. And if I leave him the cards, it would be kind of a burden to leave him thousands and thousands of worthless cards. I think I'd rather leave him just a shoebox full of really nice cards. And I've already made a video that shows a lot of the nicer cards. I could make an endless series of videos showing you all of the worthless cards. A lot of people in the comments are going to say, well, it's a full factory set. You should keep it together. Well, that's not the way it works when it comes to baseball cards. I mean, having this set of cards in a binder, it's nice in a way so that, get them out once in a while and kind of flip through them and bring back a few memories. Hey, there's a Nolan Ryan card. We're going to keep that one also. you know, Ryan was, he was such a great pitcher. He had 5,700 and something strikeouts. And the next person behind him was Randy Johnson. But he had like 800 and something less strikeouts than Ryan. Yeah. I think Ryan had like 7. Yeah, he pitched 7 no hitters. That's 3 more than any other pitcher. And I think he threw like 12, you know, games where there was just one hit. You know, 12 one hitters. And his stats say that he pitched 18 two-hitters. But he never pitched a perfect game. And, you know, he never did win a Cy Young Award either. But nevertheless, he was a fantastic pitcher. Sammy Sosa. Yeah, it's too bad I can't keep them all, but, you know, they take up a lot of space. And I have several of these hand-collated sets, you know, that are in binders. And like I mentioned, just because it's in a binder, just because it's a complete set, doesn't make it worth anything. Yeah, and I know I could send these cards to organizations that would hand them out to kids. But I think those organizations are already, they have so many cards, it's ridiculous. And I think with each passing year, the kids probably, you know, they probably end up caring less and less about these older cards. Yeah, these guys had their, they had their moment in the spotlight. Some of the photography makes you almost feel like you're on the field, right there with them. There's a Cal Ripken card. We're going to keep that. That's a keeper. And we called him the Iron Man. His full name is Edwin Ripken Jr. He was a shortstop, and he played 21 seasons for the Baltimore Orioles. You know, Ripken hit 431 home runs during his career. He won 2 Gold Glove Awards for his defense. He was a 19-time All-Star, and twice he was named American League Most Valuable Player. I guess the most famous thing he's remembered for is his consecutive games played. He played 2,632 games without missing a game. You know, that broke Lou Gehrig's streak of 2,130. And Gehrig's record stood for 56 years before Ripken broke it. You know, most people thought that Lou Gehrig's streak of consecutive games would stand forever. But, Ripken, he broke the record. I was at a game, my son and I, and that's significant because Ripken was my son's favorite player. And at that game, Ripken played the game of his career. He went 6 for 6. So yeah, 6 hits. And he scored 5 runs. And, you know, that's a big deal because, you know, before that, scoring 4 runs was accomplished only 38 times in Major League history. And I lost my train of thought, but it was one heck of a game. And what I say, yeah, 6 hits. The record before that was 5. And getting 5 hits in a game, a single game, that was only accomplished prior to Ripken. That was only accomplished 6 times. You know, so that's a big deal. But anyway, that pretty much wraps up this video. So if you like this kind of video, please tell me in the comments. I don't want to waste time, you know, fooling with a camera and stuff if you guys aren't interested in this. You know, if I had time, I could make probably 1,000 baseball card videos, but I don't have time for that. And my cat probably agrees that I probably shouldn't spend that kind of time either. So, but until next time, I appreciate you guys watching. Take care.